All right, we can do a little bit better than that. Come on, come on. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
That's good. All right. So thank you all for coming out to our carol sing this year. You got a couple of really fantastic musicians that are going to be playing and singing tonight. And I'd just like to ask Pastor Dave to come up and open us in a word of prayer.
Thank you, Josh. That's Josh Minter, our new song leader. And that's my early Christmas present, is that Josh is leading the singing and learning to do that. And hey, Josh, you know, the field is wide open, right, for what you might do as the music leader at Preston City Bible Church. We're very excited about that. Please, everyone that knows Josh, do encourage him about this. It's a big deal. We consider it a leadership role in our church to lead in song, and you're doing great. You're doing a fantastic job. And I'm trying to talk him up, but I feel like I'm talking down to you. It's because you're sitting and I'm standing. Anyway, we're so thrilled that Josh is doing this. And this is the second one of these I think you put together for us, right? The third one? Oh, did I blink? Did we have one last year and we didn't get COVID-ed out? We did it anyway, that's right. Well, good. Well, I hope everybody's doing well with their newfound immunities, their antibodies. If you've had the virus and you're recovering, we're thankful for you that you've had the one and done, and then you don't have to worry about it anymore. Those of you who haven't had the opportunity to gain natural antibodies to it, it's probably coming for you. So we're going to keep you in prayer and ask you to keep taking your vitamins. And that's whether you've gotten the jab or not, turns out. But look, we're so glad to be together as a church family and to worship God in song. I haven't taught a series on this as the pastor, but one is coming. Worship is not singing. Worship in the Bible doesn't mean singing. But singing to God is supposed to be a constant phase of Christian worship. In fact, we're told in Ephesians 5:18, if we're filled by the Spirit, that the result would be that we would sing to the Lord in song, singing and making melody in our hearts to the Lord, even as we sing to one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs. And I think music is something that holds the whole thing together in a way that really complements the teaching of the Word. We need the Word in our hearts, but we also need the words of God in song. And so I'm just so glad for these types of events, and I want to do a lot more. When I first came here, we did hymn sings on Saturday nights once a month for about 2 months. And then God has blessed us and answered our prayers with all the talent and ability that the Lord has brought through all of you who sing. And it's just such a blessing. Well, let's thank God for the celebration of his son in song, and we'll get to it. Father, we bless you and praise you for all that you are, all that you've said, all that you've done to reveal yourself to us. We could never earn the revelation you've given us through your word. So often in our time in which we live, the Bibles are dusty, if they're even present, but there's greater freedom now where we are to know you through your word than there has ever been in all of human history. Thank you that we have the sense, by your grace, we have the sense to know where the riches are in your precious words, so that we'll know you through your son, that we'll put on Christ in the power of your spirit, that we'll live out your word even as we sing and make melody in our hearts to the Lord. Father, we commit this night to you. We want to be a blessing to you. We want to praise you. We want to honor you in what we sing and what we say. And I pray that we would be excellent in doing it, for that is our destiny, to glorify and praise you in excellence. Thank you for Josh and all those that have come to share with us tonight. We ask your blessing on the evening in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you. Thank you.
So I'm going to sing a song this evening. It is probably the oldest song I've ever seen in any hymn book. It was written in the late 300s AD by a guy named Prudentius, I believe his name was. He was a lawyer from Spain who is most remembered for writing Latin poems. And he wrote this as an argument for the deity of Christ, explaining that Jesus really was God incarnate. Of a Father's love begotten, ere the worlds began to be, He is Alpha and Omega, He the source, the ending, He. Of the things that are that have been, and that future years shall see, evermore and evermore. This is He whom they of old time chanted of with one accord, whom the voices of the prophets promised in their faithful word. Now He shines the long expected. Let creation praise its Lord evermore and evermore. O ye heights of heaven, adore Him. Angel hosts His praises sing. All dominions bow before Him and extol our God and King. Let no tongue on earth be silent. Every voice in concert ring, evermore and evermore. Christ to thee with God the Father, and O Holy Ghost with thee. Him and chant and high thanksgiving, and unwearied praises be. Honor, glory, and dominion, and eternal victory. Evermore and evermore.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Says on. All right. So could we actually have Christina and Kayla and Emma, Shauna, Hannah? Could we have all the people that play tonight come on up? And Grace, you can bring him up if you want to. All right. And Pastor, you sang, so you have to come up too. Could we all give them a round of applause? They did great tonight. Well, thank you all for coming out to our carol sing. Some beautiful music and a good time. We have some refreshments downstairs, just some cookies and other stuff that's absolutely horrible for us, but tastes amazing. So please come down and join us for that. I'd like to ask Mr. Mike Regal, would you come up and close us in prayer?
Our Father, we love you so much, and we thank you for blessing us with this tremendous talent to perform and allow us to join in our own voices and sing hymns of praise to you and hymns of praise to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ in celebrating the time of his birth. And we recognize that without him, we are nothing, and without him, we would be hopelessly lost. Father, we thank you for this time of year when we can celebrate the birth of our Lord. We thank you for this time that we can celebrate together. We ask your blessing upon this refreshment now as we gather downstairs to fellowship and take of food together and continue to think about our Lord and who he is and what he has done for us. Thank you for this time. We ask your blessing upon the balance of this evening. In Jesus' name, amen.